Beef katsu sandwich. It sounds like an expensive restaurant dish. Well, I'm gonna show you an easy and affordable way to make it at home. For this recipe, we'll be using certified Angus beef flat iron steaks, about 1.5 pounds or so. This is a nicely marbled cut that is extremely tender and perfect for this sandwich. We'll start by pounding out the flat iron in order to get even pieces, about 1/2 inch thick. I like to try and push away while striking with the mallet so that you don't break through the meat. You'll want to use the smooth side of the mallet, not the tenderizing side. That would tear up such a tender cut. I use a meat mallet for flattening these steaks, but if you don't have one at home, you could use a heavy bottom pan, like a cast iron skillet. I like to use the end slice from a loaf of bread to cut my steaks to a size that will fit the sandwich perfectly. Make sure to set the trimming aside from this. You wouldn't want to let it go to waste. The trim pieces would be great for a stir fry, tacos, fajitas, or whatever you want to do with it. You should yield 4 pieces from this amount of flat iron steak. Now that all of your beef is cut to size, you'll want to get rid of that slice of bread. Sorry, little buddy, nobody wants to eat you anyway. To make these flat irons into crispy, tender little cutlets, we'll be using the standard breading procedure. You'll want to make sure that your steaks are well seasoned on both sides with salt and pepper. And another important tip is to season the flour as well. It's good to season all of the elements going into a recipe. Now we'll make the egg wash with milk and egg. When combining the flour and the egg wash, it'll create a glue for the breadcrumbs, and this will make an amazing crust. The final element is the panko breadcrumbs. These are a specific Japanese-style breadcrumb that will make this cutlet so beautifully crispy. I'm gonna use about 1.5 cups for the final breading. Make sure you fully coat the steaks in flour and then dust off any excess. Next, we'll bathe it in that golden egg wash to create the glue. Finally, we'll go into our panko. You're gonna have to get your hands a little dirty because you're gonna need to press down to make sure it's entirely coated with these breadcrumbs. Panko is really what makes this special. It really gives it the crust that you want in a katsu sandwich. Next, we'll move it to a wire rack. This will allow some airflow so that the breading can set up. Repeat this breading procedure with the rest of the beef cutlets. You'll want to make sure that each one is generously coated with the breadcrumbs. Now we'll put these in the refrigerator to set up while we make our sauce. To make the katsu sauce, we will use some ketchup, soy sauce, Worcestershire sauce, some mustard powder, and some garlic powder. You'll want to give this a good whisking to make sure that everything is combined well. The oil is preheated to 375 degrees, which is a perfect temperature for frying these. It's best to cook the cutlets 2 at a time so that they fit in the pan with plenty of room in between them. You'll cook these for about 1.5 minutes on the first side before flipping them. They should look golden brown and crisp on the bottom. After another 1.5 minutes on the second side, remove them from the oil and place them on a wire rack to drip off any excess oil. You could also use some paper towels to help soak up the excess oil. Repeat this process with the remaining 2 pieces of breaded beef. I like to give it a little baste to keep that crust crispy on top. Wow, that's that beautiful golden crust we're going for. Next, to construct the sandwiches, we'll cut the crust off of the bread. You can leave it on if you like, but I like to be a little extra fancy and make these sandwiches crustless. After arranging the slices of bread, top 1/2 of them with the katsu sauce, making sure to divvy out an even amount for each sandwich. This sauce is super tangy and delicious and really complements that crispy beef well. Now we'll top our sauce slices of bread with those crispy beef cutlets, and then we'll put the final piece of bread on top. I can't wait to dig into these crispy sandwiches, but first I'm gonna have to show you a really cool way to cut and present these. Now you could totally eat these sandwiches as is, but to showcase all of the elements, we'll cut them into 3 equal slices. You'll typically see them presented this way in restaurants, and it adds a bit of drama to the plating. Oh man, look how perfectly done that steak is. It cooks so evenly when it's shallow fried like that, and I love it with the good slathering of the katsu sauce. Add a little bit of shredded cabbage for some crunchy texture. This sandwich is one of my favorite of all time. It's crunchy from the breadcrumbs, tangy from the sauce, and the beef is so tender and delicious. If you like this video, make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.